A petition to recall Representative Tom Sullivan was approved by the Secretary of State's office this week. The move led to some party infighting within the GOP on social media, with some wondering if the recall efforts would actually bolster support for Sullivan. Meanwhile, State Representative Rochelle Galindo from Greeley resigned from the legislature this week after allegations of sexual assault were filed against her, which she claims are false. David, two different issues here. I guess I'm going to go to the one that has, I think, a little more, pardon the pun, firepower, is you see the Republican on Republican tweet storm going back and forth. And these weren't just, you know, just rank and file. These weren't just, I think, regular GOP folks. If you have folks in the Rocky Mountain Gun Owners and Tyler Sandberg, who, for folks who don't know, was part of an integral part of the Mike Kaufman office and campaign over the many years, those are some pretty serious accusations that, hey, the Rocky Mountain Gun Owners have bought and own the soul of the Colorado Republican Party. That being talked about by an Ian Silveri, no big deal. That being talked about by other Republicans, I think is newsworthy. But I'm just one person. What do you think?
Well, including, for example, Krista Kafer in today's Denver Post. There's a fundamental conflict of interest between Dudley Brown, who is a very talented email scam artist, not quite at the level of Morris Dees of the infamously misnamed Southern Poverty Law Center, but in that vein, a person with absolutely zero personal integrity, and the interest of the Republican Party. Dudley's interest is in a small and narrow Republican Party which keeps losing on the gun issue so he can raise more money. The chances of Representative Sullivan being recalled range from virtually none to none, and a far greater possibility that this will end up strengthening him both for his reelection and in general. So it's an incredibly destructive move self-destructive move for the Republican Party to go along with this. But it's a good fundraising move for Dudley, which seems to be the ultimate factor here. Former Representative Galindo situation is much more serious. That was a recall that actually started over something where she was miles out of step with the vast majority of her district in her voting to destroy oil and gas jobs. When that recall began, she tried to change the topic and said, no, this election is actually all about my sex life. Well, as it turned out, the publicity of the recall campaign empowered a victim of hers to come forward. And, you know, everything's very much, you know, the Greeley police isn't talking a lot, but you can judge the strength of the allegations. And these are not just allegations of inappropriate talk at work or something. We're talking major felonies, if proven. How fast the Democratic establishment on Saturday scrubbed everything on social media about supporting her and ordered her to get out.
Eric, it kind of seems that there's a Colorado's creating this cottage industry of social media scrubbers. You know, this army will come to your house, like the Ghostbusters, but a little bit smaller backpacks. Eric, when you look at both the Galindo resignation and the infighting between the Republican Party, what stands out to you as what we should remember from a week like this?
What stands out to me is the discipline of Democrats right now. Yeah, they can go at each other's throats on occasion, but when something like this happens, it's clearly outside the lines, out of bounds. As David pointed out, the sun didn't go down before she was gone. They enforced some discipline and some leadership, and the complete lack thereof, or the lack of any kind of broad, unified vision and strategy among Republicans. I keep thinking the Republican Party in this state has hit bottom. You know, almost like an addict, you have to hit bottom to get healthy. And if 2018 wasn't bottom for Republicans, I don't know what bottom looks like. But apparently, they haven't hit it yet. Maybe they should get rid of the elephant as the symbol. And given the party's love of guns, how about just some guy shooting himself in the foot?
I think maybe a guy holding a shovel saying, we can go deeper.
Exactly.
Susan, do you agree with the likes of somebody like a Tyler Sandberg that says trying to recall Sullivan is only going to make him stronger in a district that was, correct me if I'm wrong, was represented by a Republican just before Sullivan's? I mean, it's a competitive district, and this is only going to make the sitting Democrat stronger. What do you think?
Yeah, I agree, and it's not just any sitting Democrat. I mean, his son died. This law is named after his son, Alex, who died in the Aurora shooting. And My colleague Mike Lewin had a conversation with Tom this week that I want to read some of his quotes because, you know, if you can't relate to what I'm about to read, there's something kind of whacked about you, regardless of what policy, what party you're in. He said, "I try not to take things personally, but since the day Alex died, it's all personal to me. I tell people that since that day, I think differently, I act differently. When I see that they're trying to recall me, I know they would like me to go away. It makes people uncomfortable to see me every day." And he said, "But I'm not going anywhere." And I mean, this is not a political calculation. This is this man's life's work. This is his mission. And, you know, in a state where I would say probably half of the school children in this state missed a day of school a couple weeks ago because a young woman obsessed with Columbine flew from Florida, an unstable young woman, and bought a gun. If you can't sort of relate to what Tom Sullivan is saying, regardless of party, there's something broken about you. And I think what you're seeing is a reaction to that.
Patty, plenty of entertaining things on Twitter this week, especially from the Colorado Republican Party. Take your pick.
Well, you have Cole Wist, who had that seat before Tom Sullivan, who is standing up for Sullivan. You know, it's been said around this table before that the Republicans in this state are like a firing line, but in a circle. Here, Dudley Brown has armed them.